To the introduction given by Adam, I can make my speech much shorter because there's a continuation of our work on different Arelin bizimits. And I must say that the idea of this work was totally belongs to Renata Rybakiewicz, my former PhD student. Now she is a doctor and she works in the other university in Warsaw. So as you can see, there's the collaboration between our group and a group of Sławek and also people from Linz, from the laboratory of Serdar Sarichivci. And now Eric is he left Austria and now he is in Sweden. So there's the scope of my short presentation. First, I will be talking about the synthesis of our new compounds. One is symmetrically substituted naphthalene bizimit substituted with dietinopyrroles, and the second one is asymmetrically substituted naphthalene bizimit. Then I will be talking about optical, electrochemical, and spectroelectrochemical properties of those bizimits, and also about these properties of polymer obtained from one of these compounds. And short comments about the application of these new compounds. So we like to work with arylene bizimits because they are relatively easy to functionalize at nitrogen, and a little bit more complicated is the synthesis of the core functionalized compounds. As Adam shown already this picture, we were working a lot on triphenylamine and substituents and core substituents on different arylene bizimits with different size of the core and different place of the substitution of triphenyl groups. We prefer to work, in fact, on naphthalene bizimits because they have lower LUMO level than this molecule with small core. They have higher LUMO level than perylene, but on the other hand, naphthalene bizimits are much easier to solubilize, and the second thing is that they create less isomers, so they are much easier for purification after the synthesis. And why dietinopyrroles? This was, as I said, was the choice of Renata, probably because she had enough of triphenylamines because her thesis was devoted to these compounds substituted with triphenylamines. And as I will show you, this substitution leads for polymerization of our monomers. We did some work on different substituents. This compound is not new. It was published, many papers was published already on these compounds. But still, I think that there's some field for new research because we have found that the properties, electrochemical properties, depends very much on this substituent. For this work, we have chosen substituents, just ethyl hexyl substituent, to make our compounds more soluble. So, about synthesis. First step is known from the literature. First was dibrominated beta-alphene. Then palladium catalyzed reaction with amine to get substituted compound. And the third step was getting tributylstanyl dithienopyrrole for using Stiehl coupling in the further steps. And the second molecules which we had to prepare, also it's known from the literature, but not very nice reaction in very severe conditions, is the bromination of naphthalene core. And then, depending on the conditions of this reaction, we could get dye-substituted aryline bisimide, naphthalene bisimide, and only slightly changing the condition of the reaction, we can get also substitution at one side of the core. And the last final reaction was Stiehl coupling, CC coupling, and getting these two compounds. Adam said already a lot also about optical properties of this kind of compounds. So naphthalene bisimides have one very pronounced bend about 380 nanometers, but if it's substituted in the core, we get also charge transfer bend. And also here we can see the bend coming from the substituent. these bends are slightly shifted in comparison, this bend is shifted in comparison with not substituted molecule at the core. Also, CT bends can be seen here in this compound. They have dual character because of the different substituents on both sides. And of course, we register cyclic voltammograms. As in the other aryline bisimides, we can see two reversible couples or quasi-reversible. And on the oxidation side, we have irreversible anodic peak in the case of asymmetrically substituted compound. And here we can see peaks on the reduction, but they are connected, as I will be talking about later, they are connected with the polymerization and with growing polymer. And Przemek is right that one has to be very careful if the compound polymerizes on the surface. So every time we recorded reduction part of the cyclic voltammetry, we did it on the fresh, clean platinum surface. So we postulated that this process of reduction. This first, there's the radical anion creation, and then it's the second couple is the formation of dianion. And it was confirmed by experiments done by Sandra and Paweł. They registered EPR signal in the case of the of the reduction of the of our compounds, but on the with the oxidation was more difficult because in the case of asymmetrically substituted compound, the intensity of the signal is much lower. It's not as well resolved as in the case of radical anion because of this irreversible oxidation.
Probably made a mistake. No, just put the resistor for radical.
Ah, that's sorry. That's the of course this is the mistake. To here it should be for radical cation of this compound. So here they could register some signals, but not very well resolved and weak. And here it was no EPR signal, if I'm right. DFT calculations confirm the spatial separation of frontier orbitals, and what Adam also was talking about, the HOMO. HOMO is predominantly is lying on the diethenopyrrole substituents, and LUMO lies in the center of the at the core of the of these molecules. Calculations, theoretical calculations, were in good agreement with the founding by cyclic voltammetry. And here the substituents are not orthogonal, they twisted from the plane of the of this core, but twisted by 45 or here 47 degrees. And we also made further calculation founding the spin density during creation of radical cation and radical anion, and in the radical cation spin density is located mainly with only small extension on the substituent, and in radical anion they are again in the center of the molecule with only small again small extension to the thienyl pyrrole dithienyl pyrrole substituent. And as I mentioned before, this molecule can be electropolymerized. Here it's shown electropolymerization starting here, and the scan was done between -1.8 up to plus 0.7. Of course, it can be also polymerized by scanning between neutral state and the oxidation state, and you can see that there's peaks are growing also in the negative part of voltammogram. So here there's the cyclic voltammogram of the polymer film transferred to the solution without monomer, and we can see two reversible reduction couples and two oxidation couples. So we think that the reduction is connected with again with radical anion creation in the polymer chain and then dianion, and oxidation of the polymer is first this radical cation formation and then dication. And band gap electrochemically estimated band gap is very small, is about 1.1 electronvolt. Here we again got the results from Sandra and Paweł. They could follow the reduction of the polymer by EPR spectroelectrochemical studies and found that EPR signal grows upon lowering potential in the range of the first reduction peak. Here I didn't show, but EPR signal was fitted by Pavel, assuming three non-equivalent parameter centers. The reason of this several centers is connected with the high molecular mass of the growing polymer, which imposes different conformation in the chain. And this polymer has extremely interesting electrochromic behavior. Here the colors are not really well shown. The differences are very, very pronounced, and it gives very nice colors. So, because the EPR electrochemical studies are limited only to radicals present on the polymer, we extended our investigation to UV visible infrared spectrum, and what here we can see that in neutral state we can observe the shift of the pi-pi band merge of the which is the merge of the band coming from diethylenopyrrole and from aryline coal, and now it's shifted. It's about 470 nanometers, and also CT band is pronouncedly shifted. In the case of the oxidation of the polymer, we can see that this pi-pi band is bleaching, is totally disappears, because it's connected with this diethylenopyrroles. But in the case of the reduction, pi-pi transition band is not changed so much, because here we have the reduction only in this locally, locally influences the pi-pi bonding sequence. And some words about the applications. We have tried to fabricate the photodiode by the deposition of polymer on ITO and evaporate the metal contacts. And we have found out that dark current is increased for several up to 10 to 5 when it's under the illumination of the lamp, so it can work as photodiode. And the other application which just arrived, this was in collaboration with Professor Włodzimierz Kutner from Institute of Physical Chemistry. They fabricated supercapacitor very stable, because I didn't say that what is special about this polymer. It's very stable. It can be cycled many, many times without the loss of the current. And what's also very important, it's electroactive in extremely wide range of the potentials, unusually wide range of the potentials. So to summarize, we have synthesized two new low molecular weight donor acceptor electroactive compounds. One symmetrically substituted and one asymmetrically substituted. And both compounds showed ambipolarity, and they have relatively low band gaps. And symmetrically naphthalene bismuth can be electropolymerized, giving copolymer which has even lower band gap. And the properties of this polymer are very interesting and can be used for fabrication of sandwich type diodes and capacitors. And there are many sponsors of this work. And thank you for your attention.